when I turned 40, I had this fabulous birthday party with all my friends and family, and I gave some thought to if I really launched my career and put myself out in the media and did work in the world that was noticed and that kind of thing, that would even capture your eye, what it would be like to sit and be interviewed by you, what would I say about the decade that happened between my 40s and 50s? And it's definitely come true.
Tonight on the Barbara Walters special, we fly to beautiful Colorado to visit the 6,000 square foot Flying H Ranch, the home of Helen Carney, celebrated author and self-help media mogul. Helen has built an international self-care empire out of nothing but her own perseverance. Not bad for a girl who had little more than the love of her single working mom, supportive siblings, and extended family and friends to keep her going. Her self-care seminars and media products have changed the way women understand what's possible for their health and well-being. She has been credited with reversing the obesity epidemic through her inspirational exercise videos. America fell in love with Helen Carney when she appeared virtually out of nowhere with a hit reality television show that is now in its 8th season. It was my honor to sit down with Helen at her beautiful horse ranch on the eve of her 50th birthday. As you shoot across the sky, baby, you're here.
Probably one of the most influential role models for women today. Who are your most influential role models?
Oprah, of course. She's awesome. Love her. And let's see. You know, my mom, she's so great. She's so warm-hearted and spiritual, and she's tough. I always say my mama wore combat boots. She does. She did. She's tough. I love Michelle Obama. She's fabulous. She's really terribly sweet, and the work I did with her was just easy. She really gets it.
I want to see you all moving, all right? Okay. Exercise and moving can be fun. It's about dancing. It's about moving.
Helen, you have spent over a decade empowering women. How did you get your start?
It all started about maybe, I don't know, in my late 30s when I watched Oprah had a 20-year anniversary special where she talked about when she was a reporter and she really was struggling. Here she is, a woman, she's black, and she just got a lot of flack from her bosses, and she always, you know, struggled but carried on. And then she got this opportunity for a morning show and was really excited. And then on the first morning, the first moment when she sat down with someone and started interviewing them, she said she just felt this thing come over her whole body and like this was what she was meant to do. And when I was watching that video, I just started crying and couldn't stop because I felt like I had something that I knew I was here to do.
Did you know you would have your own show?
I had been talking to someone that was, I had said, you know, I wonder if I'm kind of like an Oprah. And they said, well, no, you're not like Oprah, you're Helen, you're a phenomenon. And so my friend and I kind of were playing around with, you know, when someone walks in the door, like when Barbara Walters walks in the door, there's a certain something about you that's Barbara Walters. And so I asked my friend, well, what, when I walk in the door, what's that like? And she said, it's like the H factor.
the self-help really helped?
I started blogging and I realized that writing, particularly about myself, was really my passion. And I remember around that time thinking, if I could just get paid to do anything around self-help and write about it and help other people, women in particular, I just knew that it had to do with women, then I would really, that would be my work in the world.
Now, when people made fun of you, your own family ridiculed and mocked you for reading so many self-help books and spending so much time and energy on self-improvement, what would you like to say to them now, sitting in your multi-million dollar ranch house with a whole media empire that spans the globe?
It took them a while to come around, but now they know who's boss. And besides, if they get too serious, I just tell them, take it easy.
You've been called a self-help guru. That self-care is something that's very important to you in your own life.
Can you say self-care guru?
Self-care.
So really my path or what I teach came out of what I had myself learned. And it's really about self-care is one of the primary pieces. And so I really felt that I wanted to change our culture, and women are needing to take a step back and actually do less. And so I sort of teach people to be a little lazy, and I think that's okay and good. And then the other part of my program is exercise everywhere, and that has been really, I think, great for myself, just to remember that everywhere I go, I can exercise. I can drop and do push-ups at any time, and it's really important to be passionate about your exercise and just little bits throughout the day. Dancing. You know, I have been so serious in my 20s and 30s as an adult, and been through a lot. And so for me, I wanted to explore being just fun and silly, and I have a very goofy side. And it's
right, turn off the lights. We're gonna lose our minds tonight. What's the dealio? I love when it's all too much. Turn the radio up, where's the rock and roll? Party crasher, penny snatcher, call me up if you a gangster. Don't be fancy, just get dancy. Why so serious? So raise your glass if you are wrong.
There's a question I need to ask you, Ellen. It's a question all of America is waiting for you to answer. What was the very first self-help book you ever read?
Well, the first one that really struck a nerve, it spoke to me because I think that women especially really deal with this issue. And, you know, especially in today's culture, this is one of the most important things for healthy, clean living. And the book was Everybody Poops.
Life wasn't always easy growing up. What was it like for you not to be in charge of your childhood? You've said that Burning Man changed your life, and it certainly changed your fashion. What was it that happened on the playa? Everyone, I have to ask, we're here in your magnificent ranch house on your 6,000 acre horse farm in Colorado. You clearly have a love of horses. Can you tell me a little bit about where that started for you? What is it about horses?
I just felt compelled to start volunteering with this horse rescue place. They do equine therapy, and I just feel like I have such a special relationship with the horses, and I feel like they feel me too. Barbara, there's one thing I want your viewers to know, is that I'm 55-0, and I can kick, and I can stretch, and I can kick, because I'm 5-0, I'm 50. Everybody can just do anything they want for interpretive dance, you know, anytime, all the time. Just get up, get high, just woo, high, let it out, let it out. Use your props, use your foot, use your everything, use your all.